don't you cry when you see I'm gone. You know there ain't no woman gonna settle me down. I just gotta be traveling on, singing.
So you're generating electricity right now, right?
Yes,
heat
too.
Vegan electricity,
heating the place so that you get thirsty.
So how much electricity do you think you're generating? Is there a way to find out?
Yeah, I have a meter right here.
Really?
Doing about
see that.
600 watts over. We're gonna break 100 miles in about 3 miles.
And how many watts have you generated?
A lot.
Robert Evangelista, I'm a biochemical engineer with Metro Energy. I make biodiesel, so I make it so you don't have to modify your engine. You don't have to modify your boiler. You don't have to modify any commercial heating apparatus. You can put it and displace foreign-made or foreign-produced petroleum gallon for gallon. You have to understand the diesel engine that was invented by Rudolf Diesel was invented to burn on peanut oil, which is a vegetable oil, and over the years
it was modified to work on
petroleum diesel. That's right. This is the source of vegetable oil, one of the two sources that we have here. Most of the vegetable oil in America comes from either soy or canola.
Really?
Soy and canola.
Mm-hmm.
And so that is taken and it's sent to a press. The bean or the seed is pressed, oil comes out in one direction, and the meal goes in the other direction. This is 100% biodiesel that's made from soy oil, which we get out of the Midwest. Would anybody like to do a sniff test?
Sure, yeah.
So can you get both of us?
We're going to do a sniff test now.
Yeah.
Okay. We don't drink this, we sniff it. 100% pure biodiesel.
So what do you call that one? It's not a Savonius, right?
It sort of looks like a vertical axis wind turbine. That's what that is.
I'm Justin. How are you guys doing? Switch to wind energy, please. Community energy.
Okay, and you say they own a lot of the wind generation facilities?
Yes, we own all these wind farms right here. All these wind farms. And any customer who lives in this territory can now choose to get wind energy from these sources. Goodbye fossil fuel burning power plants forever.
Hi, I'm Sharon Rowe. My company's Echo Bags Products, Inc. We started in New York City, 1989, with the idea of cleaning up the planet one bag at a time. Right now, it's a movement. We say we started with an idea, it started a conversation, and now it's a movement. Materials we use range from natural cotton to recycled cotton, certified organic cotton, post-consumer PET, anywhere from 20% to 80%. So we have an entire range. We also do hemp and hemp cottons. We have blends. And everything we produce since 1989 is fair wage and fair labor.
Okay, and fair wage, how is that determined? I don't know what that is.
You know, what we do is we make sure that everywhere our products come from, the labor has been certified in terms of vacation, insurances where applicable, days off, minimum work requirements, you know, and different organizations do that. For instance, where we produce a number of our goods in India, we do a lot of organic cotton. They would not get the certification if the people who are actually stitching the goods had a good work package.
Oh, interesting.
And it's been
so
like
organic
that.
Doesn't just mean not using pesticides.
No. Organic for us means from the seeds in the ground, in the soil, all the way to the every hand that touches them, there's a sustainable and ethical approach.
That's a big distinction.
Yeah.
I don't think everybody knows.
Well, and there's a lot of things on the market right now that you might think, oh, this is Go Green, and you wonder, okay, where were these produced? I mean, we want to get to the place where people ask that question all the time. Mm-hmm. Or maybe they don't have to ask it because they understand that everything is being delivered sustainably. I don't know that we're quite there yet. And the rest of our stuff, you know, we print with really funny, cute slogans. The idea is if you've got to bring a bag to the store or you want to bring a bag, it should be something that you like to carry. Echo Bags, www.ecobags.com.
Okay. Thank you so much.
On the web near you.
Okay, my name is Govinda, and the name of my company is Savia. Everything we do is eco-friendly and fair trade. My products are green because all the material that we use is 100% natural, and the printing is also done with all vegetable dyes, what we call natural dyes or herbal dyes. So they're all eco-friendly and fair trade, and they're green.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, these are... Well, what we specialize is in pea silk, that is cruelty-free silk, that in the process of making the silk, the worms are not killed.
Oh, very interesting.
Yeah.
Pea silk, I've never heard of that. So, normally a silk, when you use silk, the worms are killed, you
said? Yes, yes, in the process of making the silk, usually thousands of worms are killed. Whereas in pea silk, the cocoon is boiled once the moth flies out of the cocoon.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't get a real yarn, a continuous yarn, but we get pieces of silk, which are then hand spun and hand woven. And so the fabric has a lot of texture, which adds to a character of the weave. Thank you so much. And I wish that many people see this, understand this, and be part of this awareness and just spread the message, because we all need to take care of each other and the environment we live in.
We're here at the Green Expo, and we're here with Ralph Avalon.
And Mac McClinton.
Mac McClinton.
McClinton?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And just tell us a little bit about this booth.
Well, I'm the president of the International Green Energy Council. We are an educational nonprofit. We pride ourselves in educating from kindergarten students all the way up to international leaders about renewable energy and energy efficiency. We have many initiatives, but the initiative that we're here specifically for at GoGreen Expo is to raise funds for this amazing man and his organization called the Lower Ninth Ward Community Village Center. It's a very, very long name, and let me tell you what it's all about. Mr. McClinton was one of the first residents of the Lower Ninth Ward to lose his home when the levee broke. For 4 hours, he hung on to an electrical power cord, the transmission lines, until the water subsided. Well, when he got his insurance money, he decided that he wasn't going to rebuild his home with the insurance money. He was going to purchase an old sugarcane mill in the right smack in the middle of the Lower Ninth Ward, and he was going to create it as a sustainable community center for children to learn about art appreciation, music appreciation, sustainable building practices, and renewable energy. We partnered with Mr. McClinton so that we can create an opportunity to educate children in the Lower Ninth Ward in regards to the importance of energy efficiency, to start getting involved in the green labor market, because we believe that, as an organization, we believe that the green tech and the green revolution will become what the industrial revolution was for our great-grandfathers, and we can give them the job training that they're going to need for the future.
It's so important that they have partnered with us to get this job done, because only 10 to 15% of the original people is back. So we have to do whatever we can. And we felt like, you know, the government was our cavalry, but now we know we have to become the cavalry. And people just have to help people to help us get back. It's a big order, but if we work together, we can get the job done, you know.
So how long have you been doing this new project?
Well, I started 7.5 months ago. And believe it or not, when I thought people really didn't care, I found out people really do care. But this year was so devastating, we didn't know what to do, and they didn't know what to do. But as of now, over 1,400 volunteers have came to the space, and they haven't came there to look. They have came there to work. And it really gave me hope in seeing that, and it helped me heal, you know. Well, this year was a lab for sugarcane waste, like the stalks and stuff. And
they're retrofitting this as a sustainable community center. The irony here is that was a lab to test the possibility of sugarcane generating ethanol. And today we know that sugarcane-based ethanol uses a lot less water than corn-based ethanol production does. So it's just ironic that this, and we didn't know that when Mac obviously chose the site. This election is the most important presidential election in our country's history. That's a reality. This president will make the decisions to reverse the effects of global warming so that we don't continue to have the rise in sea level, the egregious storms that we're having. But the reality is we've already reached 1 degree of temperature rise. We're going to reach 2.
Green, green, it's green, they say, on the far side of the hill.
We are here at the Excel Meet.
booth, and we have a representative from the company here with us.
Wait, can we start over? I just got really nervous.